I'm going to show you 9 ways that you can use to fold your briefs. We're first going to have a look at some quick and simple ways that you can use to fold your briefs. Then we'll move on to some file folds, which are great for organizing and pretty quick to do as well. Lastly, we'll have a look at some rolls, which can save a bunch of space and are fantastic if you want to take the garments traveling. But let's start with this quick and easy way to fold your briefs. So with the front side facing up, we're folding the bottom of the brief up in half, and then from side to side we're folding the brief in half again. Now you can stack these on top of each other and they'll look great in your dresser. However, as you can imagine, these take up a little bit of room and they're not super easy to look through as well if you want to find a specific pair of briefs. So let's have a look at this way of folding briefs, which saves a bunch of space. You start with a brief with the front side facing up, and we're folding in 1/3 of the way on one side and 1/3 of the way on the other side so that they completely overlap. And from the bottom again, we're folding up 1/3 of the way, and we can fold the top down over it like so. Now these are great for stacking on top of each other as well, but this fold can also be used for file folding. These file folds are generally better to place next to each other in, for example, a drawer. It also works on shelves. I generally use this in drawers because it's fast to do and pretty organized as well. So the way that you file fold garments is just the same as we did with this fold. So we fold in 1/3 of the way, 1/3 of the way. And on these briefs, I like to start from the bottom so that we get this bottom part locked in there and fold them over one more third of the way like that. Then from here you can lift them up and stack them like so. Now if they're having problems standing on their own, what you can do is kind of press them in a little, and that's going to help make them stand on their own. This is not really a big problem when you get a lot more underwear, right? Because they kind of support each other. Otherwise, there are these boxes that you can use. I can add some links to the ones that I use personally in the video description if you're interested in that. And by the way, this folding method is the one that I use in the 14-day wardrobe organizing challenge, which pretty much helps you take your wardrobe from whatever state it is now, and we make it super neat and perfect and tailored to your needs. So if you want to completely organize your wardrobe, you can check out the channel membership down underneath this video. So anyway, as you can imagine, this fold is a little bit flimsy. It falls apart pretty easily, so it's not really ideal for example, taking it traveling, but we can make a little bit of a modification to that fold, which will make it look like this instead, so that the fold is pretty much locked in place and a lot better for travel. So the way that you do this brief folding hack is again by starting with the brief with the front side facing up, and we're folding in 1/3 of the way from one side and 1/3 of the way from the other side as well. And from the top, we're folding it down 1/3 of the way like this. Now we're going to open up the very top layer of the brief here. As you can see, we're going to use this to stuff the bottom inside. Now you want to use a flat palm and kind of stretch your fingers in there into the edges and corners like so. And ta-da, great for travel and standing up like that. One of you guys asked if it's possible to fold socks and underwear together. And yes, there is. So start with the briefs facing up like this, and we're folding in 1/3 of the way on one side and 1/3 of the way on the other side as well. From here, we're folding up the socks quick and easily so that they fit within the garment's width, and we're folding down in 1/3 of the way from the top first of all, like that. And then we're going to open up the very topmost layer here of the elastic band on the briefs, and we're going to fold this inside the whole roll here. So you want to use the flat palms and kind of stretch it out into the edges like that. I can adjust it a little bit, and there you go, folded together. Great for travel as well as for folding your socks and underwear together. So that was a bunch of file folding. Now I want to move on to some of my favorite folds, which is going to be the rolls. If you've been following me for a while, I'm sure you already know. By the way, I'm Tor, if I forgot to say that at the beginning of the video. This channel is all about folding and organizing and some cleaning stuff. Anyway, let's start with this quick and simple roll here. This one is really crease resistant as well, which is awesome. So we're starting with the front side facing up like this, and we're folding the underwear in 1/3 of the way like that, and 1/3 of the way from the other side as well, making sure that they completely overlap. So from the bottom here, we're going to roll up the underwear. The tighter we roll, the more it's going to crease, so be a little bit gentle with this one. Once you reach the top here, let the roll rest on the elastic band. That way it's not going to unroll. As you can imagine, this one is a little bit flimsy, so what I like to do is take an elastic band and fold it over there, and that way it stays in place. Now, if you're not a big fan of using elastic bands on all your underwear, especially if you're going out traveling, right, you can do the ranger roll instead. This fold utilizes the elastic on the underwear to hold the roll together. However, just keep in mind that this one isn't really crease resistant, but this one is a really great space saver. I'm gonna show you one that saves even more space last, as that one is really tricky, but let's start with this one. So the ranger roll here on briefs, we start with the underwear facing folding up like this. And then we're going to flip the underwear underneath like that. A couple of inches is plenty. And then from one side, we're folding in the underwear 1/3 of the way like that. And we repeat on the other side, completely overlapping the first side there. From the bottom, we're going to start rolling up the underwear. And the tighter you roll, the less space this is going to take up, but it's also going to crease the underwear more. Once you reach the top, lift it up and we flip the elastic over on one side and we repeat on the other side there as well. Now you can adjust it a little bit with your thumbs here, just stick them in there and kind of even out edges. You can give it a little massage if you're so inclined. Now this fold is great for travel as it doesn't fall apart. You can also place it standing up. If it doesn't stand on its own, just flatten it a little bit on the bottom there and you can place it like that in your drawers. Now I want to show you one more cool invention here. So this is going to be to fold underwears and socks in together in this roll. Pretty cool. So let's start with the underwear with the front side facing up. And again, we're going to fold the bottom of the underwear underneath like so. Now from here, we're going to take the socks and we're going to place them inside the middle 2/4 of the underwear here like this. And we take the other one as well, place it next to it. And we're going to fold them up in half or so like that. We're going to fold in 1/4 of the way from one side with the underwear and 1/4 of the way the other side as well, so that they kind of meet in the middle here. Now from the bottom, we're going to start rolling this entire thing up. So we roll the socks in there as well with the underwear. And once we reach the top here, we're going to lift up the roll and we're going to flip the elastic band over on one side, turn it around, and we repeat on the other side as well. And if you want, you can always make some little adjustments underneath there. Give it a little massage again if you're so inclined. And as you can imagine, this is great for like a daily shift of underwear, socks, if you just want to keep them together, have them ready in your bag. You can also use this in your wardrobe, of course. In the t-shirt folding tutorial, I also showed you how to add a t-shirt into this mix. So if you're interested in that, definitely check that video out as well. Let's have a look at one more way to fold your briefs, which is going to be the most space-saving one, but it also is going to crease up the underwear a little bit. So with the front side of the brief facing up, we're going to roll the underwear down one time, twice, and then lift it up. So 2.5 ways, pretty much like that. From here, we're going to split the garment into 3 parts. I'm going to fold back 1/3 of the way of the roll there on one side and 1/3 of the way on the other side as well, like this. Now, holding the roll tightly together, we're going to flip this bottom section underneath so that it comes up on the other side here. And from here, we're going to fold this over in half like that. And we're going to open up this layer, the very back layer it's going to be now. And we're going to stuff the underwear inside there to the degree that we can. Make sure you get it all the edges in there. Now here comes the fun part. We're going to lay it down like this and we're going to start rolling this back over. So I like to take hold of the briefs here underneath to make sure the entire bottom area is stuffed inside. And then we unroll once, all the way over on both sides. And we repeat one more time, making sure it doesn't unravel on the edges, over like that. And you can kind of stuff it further inside using your fingers like that and kind of adjust it, make sure it's nice in place in there. And there you go, the most space-saving way to fold your briefs. Again, this is going to crease up the briefs a little bit, so just keep that in mind. And that was all 9 ways to fold your underwear. Again, check out the 14-day wardrobe organizing challenge. It's now live here for YouTube members. Thank you so much for watching this video and I'll see you in the next one.